I'm better known as Two Shuus. I'm a producer and artist manager as well. So I cross-produce. I try to figure out my strength, you know, in whatever sound, but everything I try to produce, I end up being good at it. So I don't have a specific genre. So I'll say I cross-produce, yeah, depending on who I'm working with. Okay, so I've done alternative music, hip-hop, drill, high life. I'm a piano, house, reggae, dancehall. Now my favorite genre is Afrobeats, and yeah, I love Afrobeats music. But I grew up on hip hop, but now, yeah, actually, like at every stage in life, I always had I had different phases of music I listened to. So there was a point I was listening to reggae a lot, cause that's what my dad used to listen to, and I grew up around artists and producers as well. So. Some of the artist music back then, they used to do high life, so I was around listening to that as well. And during my teenage days, I became deep into hip hop. I think I just have a good music ears, and at the time I started producing, I was very desperate. You know, I felt like I was getting old, and I needed something, you know, to be dedicated to. I've not actually been producing for too long. I only started production in 2019, and this song, Kai, was in 2019, same year, like 3 months into me learning to produce. I like to walk into random studios without anything I have, trying to use what they have, because I want to be comfortable. And I think now I can sit in any room with any artist to produce. And so I'm trying to build that confidence by not relying on some particular sounds that are unique. The only thing that I take along with me is my tag, just to put on the beats after. But now I just walk into studios. Okay, so the unreleased songs by the artist, the ones that are out are only the ones I did for the day, but I have a song I produced for Tulenke and Bisake Day. I have a song for Black Sharif. I have like 2 songs. Yeah, I can't really remember everybody right now, but yeah, these are the ones I can remember now. The A&R actually was planning to put out a project last year, and so he reached out to me for beats and stuff like that. And that's how the relationship happened. And he's been up to date with my journey ever since. And so we keep in touch. And the beats I made at that point, I felt like it was that artist that should be on it. So I hit him. I was like, yo, bro, I need you to let him hear the beats. I don't want you to even put in word. Just let him hear, because I'm confident that when he hears it, he will like to work on it. So even the conversation about royalties, I don't think Ghanaian artists, especially when you don't have a relationship with them, are ready to have that conversation, because most of the time the producer is normally in a bad spot. It's like, especially when you're an upcoming producer trying to work with a popping artist, you know, like immediately even try to involve lawyers, it's a whole different thing. Like, you get me, it's long, it's a different thing. So I'm not in a rush to work with big artists anymore, because in my first year I wasn't ready, and I was sending out beats, and now when I listen to those beats, I cringe, and I feel like if it was now, it would have been better, but then I was in a rush. So now I don't, aside any other reason, one of the reasons I don't even send out beats to big artists anymore is I like to know the people I'm working with first off, have a relationship with them, you know, connect with them. So I wouldn't like to work with an artist I can't easily reach to. So right now I'm building, and that's how I and Dede met. You know, we first met, we worked on a few songs together at first, but now we are trying to build, you know, something. If the big artist reaches out to me, then I know he needs me. Therefore, he will do the needful, you get me? If I'm desperate, I'll get cheated. So that's how I feel. It may be different for anyone else. First of all, the artist is in a better spot, and the moment a producer comes out to, especially on the internet, to call out the artist, then they get blackballed by other producers. I've seen it happen. Big artists also want to work with big producers, because when the fans hear Sack or the J5, you know, it's a crazy combination. So Sack is getting his fan base, J5 is also getting Sack's fan base. So you see, they're both, you know, helping each other in that situation. But then when you're an upcoming producer trying to work with an artist like that, you come off desperate, and when you're desperate, you may sign any deal. Maybe there might be paperwork, but the deal the song may become so big, and later on when you become the big producer, you feel cheated. And yeah, I went to one of my friend's place. We were playing FIFA, and there was a new guy there, and he was like, he heard people saying my name, Shushu Shushu, and I was like, yo, what's his name again, Shushu? And they were like, yeah, and it was like, I sent two shoes. And so it was a joke at that time. Like, it was like, everyone was trolling me, like, two shoes. And then I made it cool. I was like, all right, cool. You guys want to joke with it? I'll take it. So at that moment, I actually even changed my Instagram name to Two Shoes. And then I changed everything else. They thought I was playing, but I kept it. So, yeah, shouts to him. As a producer, there are a lot of moves. But now I'm coming out as an artist. Not me singing or rapping, but then I'll be collaborating with other artists. I've actually collaborated with a couple artists. I have like three projects ready, but when I say ready, the sound, the music is ready, but it's not ready to be poured out yet because of, you know, the other stuff involved. Yeah, but before the year ends, by October, November, there's a project, and I'm a piano project with Dede Speaks and another artist in the UK called Kiddy Cole. First shout out to Beats Bakers for this opportunity. You know, the whole link up there that day was very insightful. I learned a lot. And yeah, thanks for the interview as well. And you can find me on Instagram, Twitter, Two Shoes. My Facebook is not even active, so I can't even say that. But yeah, Instagram and Twitter @2SHUUS, Two Shoes. I had to be ready to get to this spot, so I hope whoever reached out is also ready. I'm nowhere though, but I don't want my catalog to be sounding trash eventually. So yeah, I choose the people I work with carefully.